The southwest corner of Western Australia is recognised internationally as a biodiversity hotspot. And the plants that have evolved there over hundreds of thousands of years are completely unique. Kangaroo paws are a classic example found in backyards across the world these days. There are many different types of kangaroo paw, and much breeding has been done to get different colours and sizes from plants. There are a few types. The dwarf forms, often known as cat paws, the evergreen perennial forms that you'll often find in garden centres in a wide range of pots, and for some people in WA, the state floral emblem, the Mangles kangaroo paw, an annual flowering plant, is a great variety to grow from seed or possibly buy as a seedling in a punnet. There's even the stunning black kangaroo paw, which you will find in garden centres around Australia these days. They all have some common traits, and they hate being waterlogged. If your soil is heavy and prone to flooding on rainy days, build the soil up into mounds, plant them into the top of the mounds, or if it's still too difficult to grow them, try in pots. They make an amazing pot specimen and can always be split up and planted into garden beds later. The plants that have evolved in the southwest corner of Western Australia have done so in a very harsh, dry climate. Now, they do get rainfall, about 800 millimetres per annum, but it's all in a 12-week period. This tends to flush the nutrients down through the sandy soils, meaning most of their nutrients are derived from rotting organic material like leaf litter and also rock minerals that break down around them. But the biggest mistake most people make in a home garden environment is not feeding their West Australian natives. Now, here's some of my favourites. If you love the annual flower garden, it's hard not to fall in love with everlastings. In places where it rains and is cooler longer, in garden beds that tend to be sandy and free draining, it's actually not too late to plant seed if you act in the next few days. But the perfect time to plant them out is actually in autumn. The north of WA is going to be alive with everlasting flower displays this year in what's forecast to be the best flower display in over 30 years. If you can't travel north of Perth, you could always visit Kings Park to enjoy them. If there was one complaint about natives, it's they grow big and straggly, but there's been some sensational work done with breeding and there's some lovely compact forms. The thing is, you shouldn't be scared to prune them and feed them on a regular basis. And if you want to see them for yourself in the wild, well, I recommend you get over here because over the next 8 weeks, we are about to see half of this giant state of Western Australia smothered in the biggest wildflower display seen in over a generation. Take advantage of some of those cheap airfares and get yourself over here. I promise you will not be disappointed.